Margaret, let's talk about what's going on with Wisconsin Governor Scott Walker. Is he experiencing a surge in popularity right now? And if so, what's behind it?
He is definitively, unquestionably experiencing a surge in popularity, both from the grassroots and from the conservative intelligentsia. And what I think is he provides, at least on paper, before anybody's really lined up and started going, a real alternative to Bush fatigue. And
just because his name isn't Bush?
Because his name isn't Bush, and because he actually has a lot of mainstream appeal and access to major donors. And the reason he has access to the major donors is because he had, this is the good side of having three races in 4 years. His recall actually allowed him to tap major donors around the country because there were unlimited contributions that were able to participate in that recall election. And so all the major donors in New York and in California and around the country started writing him big checks. And so that means he can go longer than all the small dollar
candidates. The other part of Hoovalon was making the gas face during that.
Here's the rebuttal.
Yeah, so here's the deal. First of all, you know, I get how a blue state Tea Party governor from the Midwest is doing well in Iowa right now. He's leading one of the polls that just came out by 1 point.
15% they give.
That's right. But reality check on this. When the greatest thing you've done as governor is be so unpopular that they tried to kick you out midway in your term and survive it, that's hard to be a ringing endorsement. Second thing is, he's had an inflated reputation in Washington for a long time because the RNC and Reince Priebus and the staffers at the Republican National Committee are all Wisconsinites. And so he's a hometown hero to them. So they've been pumping up his name inside the D.C. press corps for a long while now. So there's a bit of a Walker bubble I think you're seeing as well.